Hi guys, how are you? I've been working today on the new Klaviyo sign-up forms, and I figure, well, why don't I just shoot a short video explaining to you what I like, what I really like about them, and why I am beginning to switch all my clients to Klaviyo forms. So I've been working on some examples here, and I think I want to start with the beginning, how to get from the dashboard to the sign up forms, and just kind of walk you through the process. So when you are when you log into Klaviyo, you need to navigate to sign up forms. I have a couple set up here, so let's just start over. So it's sign up forms, and then first is you need to install a code snippet on your website. So you click this button and you follow the instructions. And then once you have the code and you verify it, you go to sign up form, and then you type a name, choose a list. Where's it going to? Let's say I'm just going to do newsletter right now, and then choose whether you want to do a flyout or pop-up. I'm going to do pop-up right now, but I think for my mobile, I'm going to try this format. I really like it. So let me just do this one. We also have the enable GDPR fields, which are really, really nice, but I'm not gonna get into this right now. I just wanna show you a really basic form. So let me go save and continue. And here we have a very basic form that we can build on. I've already done some samples, so let me just go with my sample and I'll explain it to you exactly what I like about and what I have done. So there's not that much documentation out there telling us how to make those opt-ins. And to be honest, I thought that they were very limited until I came across the blog today that showed me a couple other examples, and that made me realize that they extended the way they are done. And now we have actually more possibilities. When I was at the Klaviyo workshop in Los Angeles last month, they really didn't have any of that. I even asked if we can do that, but it wasn't available yet. So it's nice to see that they've added all that additional functionality where we can add different images and just really customize them. So that's why I decided to go for it. There's quite a few more things, but that was the first thing, because I like my pop-ups to use really good images. It's very important for conversion. So in any case, I've just kind of done a dummy example here. And let me walk you basically through this. So when you log in, you have this panel, and it's very similar to how we create emails. You can drag and drop whatever you want, text, button, image, and then style it the way you want it. So I'm going to move on here to styles, because this is where it got really interesting and fun for me. So first of all, I didn't know we have all these different sizes and options, which I really like. So we can do small, and this one's my image, large, and then I use custom because I like my pop-ups to be bigger. I always kind of felt like when I do them this size, they convert much better. So let's say this one is 750, and then I've added an image, which is a background image in this case. So I've created a background that half of it is an image and half of it is white. But you have different options that you can use. There could be custom, cover, and contain, which I didn't really play with those two. I played with custom and cover really worked best for me. So basically you need to just figure it out. The size of your pop-up, and the width is 750. So I created an opt-in that it's 750. I created a JPEG that is 750 pixels wide, right? And then I center it. Now to move all these fields, all you need to do is set up the padding right here. So for me, it worked this way. I also added some, and I need to take out the label because I don't want this. And yeah, it's just really that easy. And then what else I have done, and I have my success page, which also has the same image, and I just added some text right here. I am not sure if I can change the image right now for a different one for the success page, to be honest. I didn't test this, but I know that the functionality is still limited, but I think it's actually really good for what I need. Okay, so here is the fun part, the behaviors, where I have it set up that the pop-up shows up 60 seconds after the page loads, and then it's gonna come up after they scroll about 60%, because that really shows an intern that they are a little bit more interested in the content. I also, you know, I use Opt-in Monster, and I always kind of struggled with the cookies and stuff. I just never know whether it's really working properly or not. Here, I just set it for 14 days and for desktop. And what I really like about this is that you can check don't show to existing Klaviyo profiles. So everyone who is already in Klaviyo, they won't they won't be seeing this pop-up. So I just, you know, I felt like with Opt-in Monster, I never knew whether this is working or not. So here, I'm actually really, really happy to see this. So I'm actually really happy with the way this looks. And I also am very happy that I can add different checkboxes, which is something that you can't do in Opt-in Monster. So I can just go in here and add, and not only that I can add these. So for example, this could be option one is if they're interested in a newsletter or if they want to get their emails weekly, monthly. There's all kinds of different combinations, and then we add the value here, and then right away this will show. The value will populate into Klaviyo. So I really like that. I don't know how to. I really like, you know, that this will translate right away into a profile. Here we can add the profile property, and also right away, you know, we can add the lead source, for example, and. It gives me much more flexibility and much more information. I think Just Uno was able to do that and Opt-in Monster wasn't. So I really like that this functionality here is going to be available. Plus, I think that for GDPR especially, you know, anyone who needs to comply with GDPR, I think this is going to make everyone's life much, much easier. And just to show you some examples, I'm gonna go back to my, actually I'm gonna create a new one. And then when you do create, let's just do another test. And then let's just choose another list. And then we do enable GDPR. This is already going to be populated with the right boxes and the right copy. Obviously you can customize however you want it, and you can add an image wherever you want it and stuff. So, and then for example, if we add an image here, we go to the library and we just do this, and then I can do, you know, let's say 500 or, let's see, it's gonna be something. Oh, this image's got a white background, so it won't really work like that, but you can kind of understand that you can do, I mean, client's account, I don't really want to mess with the images or the other settings, but you can understand, you know, how this can be customized. Or let's say we can delete this, and then I think I can add an image. I don't know if I can, this was the thing, I don't know if I can add the image that would go like the whole length, but anyways, you know, you can just play with it. It really is super easy. And I love the fact that all of this will translate into Klaviyo. Like right here, we know that it's email and it's web, and you can pull out and it's consent, which means the proper profile will show that whoever sign up for this email, for this opt-in, gave consent, and you will be able to see where this came from. So I really like this. I think that makes life easier. And I think this is a great beginning. You know, they will be, I know Klaviyo is working on it. They're gonna be making more improvements. And also I understand that it's not working in Internet Explorer, but I don't think you can check in Google Analytics how many people are actually using Internet Explorer. Most people are anyways are on the phone. So at least that's from my experience. So in any case, I hope you find this helpful. And I think that, you might want to consider using Klaviyo Forms. Another plus is that it does save money because you don't have additional cost. So I think overall, this would be a great direction. This is definitely a direction for me. I know OptinMonster have tons of other functionality, but I'm not sure if I really need it that much for e-commerce. Okay, so you can do exit intent as well. So it has the most basic functionality that everyone needs. So I think it's great. Anyways, let me know in the comments below what you think of it. And if you have any more ideas or suggestions or anything that you want to add to it, I would love to hear from you. I just wanted to do this, let you know really how easy it is, and it's probably a good idea to start using it. But if you think you don't, please also let me know. Let me know why you wouldn't be using it. I would be curious to hear. Okay, thank you so much.